You think fertility is mostly a woman's issue? Think again. Male factor infertility is involved up to half of the time in couples that are trying to conceive. The good news, most of the causes of male factor infertility are treatable and manageable. In this video, I'm gonna break down the top causes of infertility in men, how common they are, diagnosis, and treatment options. Let's get started. I'm Dr. Laura Shaheen. I'm a double board certified OBGYN and reproductive endocrinologist helping people build families for over 20 years. If this is your first time finding the channel, welcome. Be sure and subscribe so you get my weekly educational videos all about reproductive health. I love educating, and there are two other ways to stay in touch. Number one, see the link in the description below for my newsletter. It's a weekly updated newsletter where you learn about fertility in the news, my most recent educational content, and some recommendations every single newsletter. The second way to learn and get more information is my weekly Brave and Curious podcast. You can listen anywhere you listen to podcasts. I've got a playlist here on YouTube, Apple Podcasts, Spotify. Every week, I either do a solo episode where I do a deep dive into a topic, or I interview either an expert in the field or a fertility warrior that is sharing their story. Now, today we're gonna talk about common causes of infertility in men. This is such an important topic. Too many people still believe that fertility is the woman's problem and that she should be the focus in the couple, but male factor infertility is an issue up to 50% of times in couples that are struggling to conceive. Infertility is common. It impacts 1 in 6 couples that are trying to conceive. Up to 50% of the time, there's a male factor component. If you can learn the cause of the fertility issue and have it treated, you can meet your family goals sooner. Today, we're gonna go over the 5 top causes of infertility in men. We'll go over each one in detail and talk about how common it is, how to diagnose it, and how to treat it. Now, stick around to the end of the video where I give you 3 important questions to ask your doctor about your personal situation so you can make the next steps that are right for you. Causes of infertility in men, 1, low sperm count. This can happen up to 40% of the time. It's diagnosed with a semen analysis. You get lots of information on a semen analysis, but if the concentration of sperm is less than 15 million per ml, that's considered a low count. Usually the first step is to repeat the test, because I tell my patients semen analysis are like snowflakes and it can be a little bit different each time that you check. So you want to make sure it's consistent. But if you are finding that you have a low sperm count, then this is something that you should absolutely figure out why and treat, because if you can improve the sperm counts, you can improve your chances of conceiving sooner. So for treatment of a low sperm count, it totally depends on the cause. If there's a physical cause like a varicocele or a dilated vein in the scrotum, then that could be treated surgically. If there's a hormonal cause like thyroid disease, prolactin dysfunction, or some other hormonal dysfunction, that might be treated medically. I always ask my patients about prescription medications. There are some prescription medications that can specifically lower sperm count, and I review very carefully lifestyle optimization and changes it could make to improve the overall sperm count. And finally, look at supplements. You have to be very careful when you're sourcing your supplements because they are not regulated by the FDA. Look for third-party testing, because often you could be taking something that is lowering your sperm counts because it's not listed on the bottle. So you just gotta be really, really careful about. As far as treatments for low sperm count, if you can identify the issue and treat the issue, then the sperm counts can increase. It can take 3 to 6 months to see a dramatic increased amount of sperm in the semen analysis, so it can take time. But looking at all of the things that we talked about, optimizing lifestyle, thinking about maybe some antioxidant supplements, talk to your doctor about the ones that might be right for you. With time and a lot of consideration, sometimes the sperm counts can increase and you can build your family sooner. Other treatments for a low sperm count can be interventions like intrauterine insemination, where we wash and prep the sperm, and at the time of ovulation, we're placing the sperm into the uterine cavity to kind of get it closer to where it needs to be. And then of course, there's in vitro fertilization, or IVF, which is an amazing way to help eggs and sperm find each other in the lab And if there's a significant low sperm count or sperm issue, we can help with fertilization with a process called ICSI, and it's an acronym, I-C-S-I, intracytoplasmic sperm injection. I have lots of educational content here on YouTube under the male factor fertility or fertility playlist that talk about the difference between IUI versus IVF, benefits of IUI. I have a whole video here on ICSI and understanding if that's right for you. So the first step is to figure out why there's a low sperm count and try to treat that issue. And then the second option, or can really help you conceive sooner, is using treatments that might be available to you. Talk to your doctor about what is right for you. Causes of infertility in men, number two, low sperm motility or morphology. This can occur alongside low sperm counts or independently. You could have a normal sperm count but low motility and low morphology, and it can happen around 30 to 40% of the time on a semen analysis. Remember, the first step is to repeat that semen analysis and then look for causes, like why could this be happening? Treat those causes, and then you might see an improvement. Many of the same causes that I mentioned previously for low sperm count can also cause low motility and low morphology. So you wanna do the same type of deep dive and discussion with your doctor and testing, looking at prescription medications, physical causes, hormonal changes, supplements you could be taking, and lifestyle optimization to improve the sperm to help you conceive sooner. Causes of male fertility issues, number three, a varicocele. I mentioned this briefly. A varicocele is a dilated vein within the scrotum that heats up sperm as it's being made, and that can drastically impact count and function. This can occur about 15% of men overall, and when men have infertility and abnormal sperm counts, it can show up and be a cause up to 40% of the time. So why is a varicocele an issue? Well, sperm is in the testicles and it's in the scrotum, which is outside of the body, because sperm does best about 3 degrees lower than body temperature. So how can a varicocele cause sperm issues like low count, low motility, low morphology? Sperm does best at a temperature lower than body temperature. Sperm is in the testicle, which is in the scrotum, which is outside of the body, because sperm likes to be about 3 degrees lower than regular body temperature. And so if there's a varicocele, which has a dilated vein, and that vein is filled up with body temperature blood, that can heat up the testicle and really impact the production and function of sperm. A varicocele can be diagnosed in two ways. Number one, a physical exam, and number two, a scrotal ultrasound. So not all varicoceles will necessarily cause low sperm counts and sperm function issues, and not all low sperm counts and sperm function issues are due to a varicocele, but this is a part of the evaluation for abnormal sperm counts and male factor fertility, because you don't want to miss it. And sometimes people do a varicocele repair and they do an updated semen analysis 3 to 6 months later and they don't see a change. It's important to understand the procedure, risks, predicted outcomes, and go over it very carefully with the surgeon before you decide to get a varicocele repair. Causes of male infertility, number four, hormonal imbalances. It's actually less common than you would think, impacting less than 5% of men with male factor fertility. But things to look for, like we talked about, is thyroid disease, prolactin disease, looking at gonadotropins like follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone that are made by the pituitary gland to talk to the testicle to help it make sperm and testosterone. If the FSH or follicle stimulating hormone or LH luteinizing hormone is significantly high in men, sometimes that can reflect a shutdown of the function of the testicles. It's the pituitary gland is saying, hey, wake up, like you need to be making sperm. And it can really show a dysfunction in that whole hormonal axis and functioning of the testicles. Your doctor will likely also check estradiol levels. Just like women make testosterone, men make estrogen. And sometimes there's an imbalance in the estrogen testosterone levels. As far as diagnosis, it's really with blood tests of the tests that I've just mentioned, and often testosterone, free testosterone and total testosterone will be checked with a blood test as well. Treatment for hormonal imbalances depend on what you're trying to address. So if it's thyroid disease, disease, you're going to treat the thyroid. If it's a prolactin issue, you're going to decrease the production of prolactin, likely with a dopamine agonist. And if it is an estrogen and testosterone differential, sometimes you'll take different medications. Sometimes men will actually take Clomid and letrozole, or sometimes even gonadotropins like FSH and LH, in order to encourage the testicles to make more sperm. You know what men should not take if they are trying to get pregnant? Testosterone. I just cannot say this loud enough, because I often see men who come to me, I'm a second, third, fourth opinion, and a previous doctor who's truly trying to help and says, oh, this couple wants to get pregnant, there's a low sperm count, I'm going to give testosterone because that's going to help with the sperm production. It does the exact opposite. If the testicles are seeing exogenous testosterone in shots or creams or pills, then the testicles are going to get lazy and say, oh, I don't need to make any testosterone, I'm seeing it from an outside source. And so then the testicles are not going to make their own testosterone, and guess what else? They're not going to make sperm. So if you are trying to get pregnant, do not take testosterone. It is actually going to act like a birth control for men. And so you don't want to give testosterone, but these other medications that I talked about, like Clomid and letrozole and gonadotropins like FSH and LH, those medications will encourage the testicles to make their own testosterone and also increase sperm production. Not always, and again, it can take 3 to 6 months to see an improvement, but this is something that sometimes could be offered to men with low sperm counts or low sperm production, and it can truly be beneficial. Causes of male factor infertility number 5, lifestyle issues. This is so important. If you can improve your overall health and well-being, you can improve your reproductive health. It just makes logical sense. And so I know it can be overwhelming where you just sort of say, like, improve your lifestyle, be healthy, that's gonna help your sperm. But it is really true. I think about it in a couple of different segments. I think about habits to quit or modify, and then other habits to adopt and really make healthy choices. So as far as habits to quit or modify, smoking, tobacco, vaping, horrible for sperm production, absolutely changes hormonal levels, decreases testosterone production. So many toxic chemicals, especially in vaping, contraptions with the heavy metals. No smoking, no vaping. Marijuana, not good for sperm production. I get a lot of pushback in my patients in Washington State where it's legal. It's sort of like, gosh, this is legal. A lot of doctors prescribe it for medical reasons, you know, like nausea or, you know, side effects from chemotherapy. Therefore, it's got to be healthy. But I do have a video here on the implications of marijuana and THC on sperm production and function. At a minimum, modify and just be aware of the risks. If you've got a low sperm count and marijuana is a regular part of your life, it is something that you could change and see if the sperm production is improved. Another thing to modify is alcohol. I know alcohol is a big part of community and social events and relaxation for a lot of people, but it is really hard for our bodies to process, and it actually can disrupt sleep, which is really not great for your metabolism and hormonal function. And so really limiting alcohol in quantity and sort of, you know, to special occasions is usually the right thing to do. There's a lot of recommendations out there, and friends and families will give you tips when you're trying to conceive, talking about like which underwear you wear or whether you should go bike riding and things like that. And truly the one lifestyle thing that can impact sperm function and production is hot tubs. So hot tub use 3 or more times a week can be shown to decrease sperm counts. But other things like some like dry sauna every once in a while, bike riding, whatever underwear you wear, really the studies have not shown that it makes a huge difference. But that's where that sort of theory is coming from. Something else I talk to a lot of my patients about is endocrine disruptors and toxins in everyday products like plastics, BPA, parabens, PFAS. A high exposure to these things can disrupt our hormonal function and decrease sperm production and function. And we cannot eliminate our exposure to these things, but there's small changes that we can make, like in our kitchen, kind of not heating up food in plastic. plastic, not storing leftovers in plastic, using a glass or stainless steel water bottle, thinking about the products that you're using, even like fragrance-free laundry detergent. That one step could be really helpful at decreasing the amount of endocrine disruptors that you're being exposed to. I've got a lot of information on lifestyle optimization on my lifestyle YouTube playlist, where I kind of go through different endocrine disruptors, the evidence that it impacts sperm production, and really, you know, not overwhelming, but just solid tips on how to decrease exposure. You can't eliminate it, but decreasing it could improve your reproductive health. And finally, focusing on overall health and well-being. I know that's a big topic, but you've got to think about nutrition, exercise, sleep, and stress management. All of these things can help your overall wellness, and that's only going to improve your reproductive health. So this can be avoiding extremes in exercise, but keeping your body moving, making sleep a priority. We can't eliminate stress, but we can certainly manage it and work on relaxation techniques that can help us. And then finally, for nutrition, you want to have more fresh fruits and vegetables, less processed foods. You want to think about foods that are high in antioxidants. Antioxidants are amazing for sperm, and you can think about that for the diet that you and foods that you're choosing, as well as supplements. Antioxidants are vitamin C, E, zinc, selenium, and coenzyme Q10. That does not mean that you need to rush to the store and buy a shelf full of supplements to take, but things like walnuts, leafy vegetables, some citrus fruits with vitamin C, a lot of these antioxidants can be really, really helpful to decreasing the free radicals and oxidative stress around DNA as sperm is being made. And so choosing a diet high in antioxidants and considering a multivitamin, which will have a lot of antioxidants, and maybe adding the coenzyme Q10, got a great video here that talks all about that very specific antioxidant. Sometimes that could be helpful. Be sure and talk to your doctor before you start taking any supplements and review exactly what's right for you. We have covered so much, but I hope that this information is helpful. Let's do a recap. We talked about 5 common causes of infertility in men. Number 1, low sperm count. Number 2, low motility and morphology. Number 3, a varicocele. Number 4, hormonal imbalances. And number 5, lifestyle choices that could be altered to improve your overall well-being. We went through each cause and how common it is and how to diagnose it and treatment options that are available. And I hope this information is helpful. I'm glad you stuck around till the end, because I want to give you 3 important questions to ask your doctor about your male factor fertility. Question number 1, should we do a semen analysis? The answer is yes. And then if it's abnormal, can we repeat it? I really want you to get the testing done. Question number 2, are there lifestyle changes or supplements that I could take, diet, nutrition, exercise, things that I could do to optimize my overall health, with keeping in mind that the goal is a healthy sperm count and trying to conceive? And number 3, should I see a reproductive urologist or a fertility doctor about my semen analysis results and options for treatment, like intrauterine insemination or IVF? So the questions are testing, lifestyle optimization, and treatment options. These are really important to go over. And if your doctor gives you a recommendation, say, okay, great. So if we try this for 6 months and I'm still not pregnant, then what? It's really nice to have a game plan. I hope you found this information valuable. Like this video, comment with questions that you have. Be sure and subscribe to this channel so you get my weekly videos all about reproductive health. And until next week, wishing you love, luck, and pineapples.